Well, tonight, we are tackling the issue head on, connecting you with resources to help. And we have a panel of experts on standby to answer your questions.
But first, a story of hope and recovery. Reporter Grace King introduces us to Griffin Bond.
I mean, I would have never imagined then that I'm going to school to help people. I'm working in treatment to help other people just start the process of recovery.
Griffin Bond's struggle with addiction began at age 12.
I just didn't fit in. Like something that I never felt okay. And so I started acting out, becoming a class clown, you know, trying to gain acceptance.
He began smoking cigarettes, then marijuana, then prescription medications.
It progressed from over the years of just that becoming a habit occasionally or socially to become dependent.
Then he hit rock bottom.
I was 23, about to be 24, and I just realized there was nothing. I looked at the past 5 years of my life, I did nothing with it. I was like, I'm gonna be dead. And I just knew there had to be something different than this.
He went to a treatment center in Florida, got the support he needed, and began to turn his life around.
I came back from unemployed, no place to live, to a job and, you know, stable housing, and got to have some responsibility and pay, and it gave me purpose.
It took a recovery program for him to find happiness, and eventually, his wife.
He's the most amazing man that I've ever been with in my entire life.
Today, Griffin is a stepfather.
It's given us a family.
A student.
I'm in school to be a psychiatric nurse practitioner.
And a recovery advocate, 6 years clean.
You never have to use again.
For Griffin and Brittany, recovery gave them a second chance.
There is hope, there is freedom.
One, they want others to have too.
There's people waiting on you to get clean. There's people, you are so needed.
I'm Grace King, reporting.